I'm putting on some cinnamon, spring a little cayenne, you know, maybe a pinch of Himalayan salt, whatever, and yum, yum, yum. Sometimes I put on sprouts, skip the honey, put on sprouts. I mean, I lived off sprouts for years. I did that. I was in a raw food community for years. So I understand the need to identify with a food path, but it's really not that important. I identify with the path that's a common path, that it's a common ground, it's the middle way, and it's where the heart speaks to all hearts, and it's love. And so the reason I laugh about everything and I kid people about everything, because everything is too serious to really get serious about. And it's hilarious at the same time why we're serious. When we're making this shit up as we go, why not make up a beautiful dream? Now, there was a song from The Who, 1968, in which it was Peter Townsend. And Peter Townsend says, funk. It's a funk. It's a put on. Living in a funk. It's a put on. Living in a funk. It's a put on. Get it? Living in a funk. It's a put on. You've been programmed away from your joy. Somehow your joy has been hijacked. I don't know if anybody's paid attention here, but if anybody's living in a funk, you're allowing it. If you're living in a funk, you're giving permission. You're conceding. You are acquiescing to the programming, no matter who's doing the narrating and who's running the show of behind the program and the propaganda machines. You're selling out. Now, I don't know how to tell that to 7.8 billion people other than to be a free, sovereign, independent, infinite being that I am. And get to this place, and then you have bragging rights. Yes, yes, yes. When your mind is free from all enslavement, mental slavery, psychological slavery, religious slavery, sexual slavery, food slavery, family slavery, any kind of dogma that's running you, you're owned, you're a slave. And it doesn't matter, even if, you know, about the corporate, if you guys are watching me in the United States and people going, oh my God, there's been hundreds of years of us being, no, and it was since 1870, we became corporate property. Of a corporation, of a fake United States, which wasn't a republic. And once we've returned to the republic, which has already taken place, except the word hasn't gotten out to everybody yet, that we're operating now from constitutional law. And as a sovereign being, you don't owe anybody an explanation about anything. I hope you're paying attention, my friends. Someone starts getting into your shit, starts getting into your business. Remember this, you don't owe anybody any information about any business that you do, anything you're involved with, any area of your life. It's none of their fucking business. And what people think about you is none of your fucking business. Get that straight. Got that? Breathe. We're not pulling any punches in 2021. We're telling it like it is, going right for it. Right for the gut, right for the heart, right for the ass. We're just going to clean out. And go free. And go free. When you want to just go free into the next moment, you will jump with a leap of faith. A faith so strong, you will never have ever again any fear, any doubts, any concerns, any butterflies in your stomach. If you do have concerns, butterflies in the stomach, take a breath. They'll be gone the moment you see right through them. They'll just poof, disappear like they were never there. You see, it's all the mental realm. And you're also in the middle of the manifestation mind. The manifestation mind, where you have to go to Annie's classes. I'm promoting Annie now again. Go to her classes. She's teaching the manifestation mind and all those lovely wisdom teachings. And her heart knows that material inside and out. So go see her. So drink freely from a wellspring of abundance. and you will be blessed beyond measure. You will be given health, wealth, joy, and freedom, feeling connected to all water, all air, all fire, all earth, all spirit, all plasma, all vibrations that coexist in this realm of love. You know, I didn't grow up thinking that I was going to be the voice of P. I'd be the P-man and become a P-fessor of urinology. In case you didn't know it, but if you looked at the back of my new book, The Manual for Urine Therapy Teachers and Therapists, there's an endorsement from the Professor Emeritus of Colorado University, Dr. Vijay Gupta. And he gave me one of the highly respected endorsements for the manual and for the subject matter. And also in 2018, when my other book came out, Healing Water from Within, he gave me an honorary PhD doctorate at University of Colorado, at CU, Colorado University. And so I am a professor. I am a professor. I have a doctor in urinology, pisology, call it whatever you want, G. And what a grace go I. And I've been asked to talk to a doctor about urine therapy. I'm the guy. You know, what am I going to say? There are a whole world of people that have faith in me. And I have faith in the being known as me. I have faith in the presence known as me. I have faith in the grand scheme of things. In the grand scheme of things, everything's already played out. Everything is happening automatically. Everything is in divine order. And our job is to walk fearlessly through every moment. Take a breath. Our job is to walk fearlessly, courageously, strong, standing tall in your light, in your joy, in your power, in your grace, in your gratitude, in all of that. And in your immortality, and notice the transformation of every moment with your heart open, with your eyes open, with your ability to see things that you can see. And I'm able to see things now I didn't see. I mean, the fact that I'm going for a hike and I'm getting all kinds of ahas and insights and revelations about my whole life, about anything I want to call up, boom, there it is. And here comes the Who singing, "It's a funk, living in a funk, living in a funk, it's a put on. living in a funk, it's a put on, it's a put on." You guys, it's a put on. If you're living in a funk, you're doing it. If you're living in a pity party, feeling sorry for yourself, guess who set that one up? If you're hurting and you're regurgitating, you're hurting, and you keep playing with your trauma and your pain body, you're playing Russian roulette with your emotions. I mean, there's still a bullet in the chamber. You're likely to blow your head off. You're likely to take yourself out. If that's your intention, and your death urges and your death wishes are activated left, right, and center, you better breathe and go see a breath worker and stop watching television. As a matter of fact, kill your TV, throw it down the tube, get rid of it, right? And get into spiritual community as soon as possible. Get involved with anyone as soon as possible. Start being honest with yourself as soon as possible and allow some fun into your life. That's my story. I'm sticking with it. Satsang for tonight over, baby. Any questions, any comments, any feedback, any reply? Good. Thank you.